Outdoor Adventures Productions brings you this week's Bayou Country Outdoors. With your host, Susan Melton, and Maurice Fontenot. And now it's time for this week's Bayou Country Outdoors. Welcome to Outdoor Adventures TV Magazine. Well, folks, we've had a fairly mild winter this year with very little rain and higher than average temperatures. If you look closely, you'll see that many of the trees and bushes are already in bloom. The warm air temp also indicates warmer water temperatures, and that means the bass are already sitting on their beds. Now, the lack of rain, well, that means lakes and rivers are crystal clear. Now, if you're in the same mindset as Susan and I, this can only mean one thing. It's time to sight fish the bedding bass. You can easily see the male bass on the beds, and this always provides extra excitement when you see the lure inhaled by that big bass. For this week's show, we're fishing a flooded timber lake where there are both underwater and above water levee structures holding bedding bass. So stay tuned, and we'll be back right after these messages.
Got one.
All right. On a worm?
Lizard.
Oh, a lizard?
Yep, on a little lizard. It's been so long since I lifted a bass.
What, you got a watermelon colored lizard?
Yeah.
Not big.
Yeah.
Good choice. This water's good and clear.
Mm-hmm. So, that was a good little catch. Nice little, on a nice little lizard, I caught a nice little bass.
I tell you what, there's some more in there. I saw two or three moving when we first come up to this cut.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Probably on the backside of those points.
Well, hopefully if they see my little lizard, they'll bite again.
There's a duck that didn't want to be involved.
Yeah. Oh, he's chasing another one. That's all. Oh, there goes another one trying to bite. Come on. Come back. Oh, that was a bass.
Yeah, I know.
Over
I heard
there.
That. That was a big fish.
Ooh,
it's overcast. Folks, it's mid-February. It's 80 degrees today. It's been warm for 4 or 5 days. The fish are already moving up on the beds along the banks. And if you find you a place where you can find you a good embankment like this and look for clear spots in the water, in the grass, that's where you're going to find the bass. There's now, right now, we're finding all the little male bass sitting on the beds. The females backed off 4, 5, 8 feet from them. And sometimes we pick up both fish.
All right, let's try it again, see.
He hits it gorilla, his tail.
Do what now?
He hits it, pop it to him, hit him hard. That's one thing a lot of folks won't do when they're fishing with heavier plastics like big lizards and stuff. There's a lot of plastic there. You got to really pull that hook through that plastic.
See, I did do that. And, I guess I've...
You've been on speckled trout too long, lady.
That's probably...
You think he's going to hit you a third time?
Come on, come on.
He might if he's got a nest sitting there. He might be just picking it up and moving it off the nest.
Yeah, he's probably mad because I'm getting too close to home, huh?
Yeah, really. I got him, but I think he's got me too. He's curled up and underneath. I still feel him pulling. Underneath this thick, look at this thick stuff I threw into, Susan.
Cool.
I threw a tube up here. See if I can let him work himself loose. I don't know if he's still on there now. I felt him pulling for a second. Yeah, he wrapped.
Oh, yeah, he's smart. He wrapped around that big one. Is he off?
I see my bait. He's a good fish. I saw him. I saw him come to the surface. He's probably 2 pounds. But look how thick that stuff is down in there.
Oh, yeah.
But it's shallow up in here, and this is where those fish are going to bed up for the spring spawn.
That's it.
Not for the winter thaw. Fish. Easy. White line. Oh, yeah, maybe better. There it is right there. Away from the edge of the boat. Come on, baby. Come on out here. Taking drag still. Look at that.
Yeah, it's a nice bass.
Hey, you made me lose my... Oh, there's my tube. I thought I lost my tube. That might be better than five.
Oh, yeah.
It's a good hefty fish, good football. Put a scale on it real quick. Get these Berkeley scales out. See what we come up with. Get them zeroed. I don't want this fish out of the water too long. Can you see that?
We can see the fish, yes.
Can you see the dial? 5.8? Well, it was 5.8.
Turn it and let me see it.
Let me resume. Ow!
Oh, you got
bit me, woman.
That's what you get for catching her.
5.8.
Yeah,
that's 5.8. Now, 5 pounds, 8 ounces, 5.8 pounds. It's a good fish. All right. On a real light line, folks. Well, 12 pound line, which isn't super light, but fishing little tubes. And let me show you what we're doing. These are the Berkeley power bait tubes. 4-inch tube. We're using the Gamagatsu extra wide hook, which really helps in these tubes because you have to get it through there. And we're using a 16th ounce weight and rigging it Texas style. Now our preference for this kind of fishing is tear this tube up and get another one because it's gone. Our preference is light line, 7-foot rods like we use for speckled trout fishing, where we can throw light stuff and still have the sensitivity. And that's an important thing. If your rod's too stiff or too short, you can't make a cast with this light stuff. Now one of the things that we like about fishing with the tubes and the way I rig it, if you can come in close and look, I put that extra wide gap hook through and then just take the tip, lift it up and kind of stick it in like this so that it becomes weedless. And I really didn't hook this just right. I went in too far. You can fish with these tubes in real finesse situations. And I am messing this one up big time. And the tube floats when it hits the water and then sinks. And as it sinks, it belches air and makes a bloop, bloop type of sound. And that's usually when these fish hammer it. Okay. So when it's rigged, it looks like this. And it's a very, very effective bait when fish are on their beds for sight fishing. See the fish moving. You can throw it in there and it doesn't hit with a clunk. It hits very light, and that's what you want. You don't want to make much sound when it hits the water. Because if you do, you'll spook them off. And I'm sitting right over where I thought that. You change back to the lizard?
Yep.
Oh, good Lord, you got one that's really
active. See, I was on that tube and it wasn't doing nothing for me.
Well, what'd you say? Why'd you change? Confidence,
because
right?
Because don't do it just to get a show, man. This is a heavy one.
You made a good point. You fish with what you're confident with.
Yeah. I mean, he was doing good with his tube, and I had caught one on a lizard, so I said, well, I'm going to go back to it and see if I can get me another bass.
That's a pretty good little fish.
Yeah,
there.
He's a little bit bigger than that last one I had. But he's going to go back in. Bye. Nice little bass. And I just put it on and threw in, so...
Well, you might go back to that same spot, because you know what we found in the past. Sometimes you'll pick up the male, then the female. In that case, that was probably the female.
Yeah. Not a very big female, huh?
Yeah. It could have been a big male.
Yeah.
Hard to say.
Yes, now I feel confident. Confident.
Watermelon.
I feel confident.
Berkeley lizard.
That's it.
I'm waiting.
Well, now I just want to tell the viewers that sometimes the other guy may be very successful with his bait, and Maurice has been fishing out here a little bit more than I have, and that's what he's been using. And I haven't fished out here in a while. I haven't done bass fishing in a little while, but I feel confident with my lizard and my worms. So, you know, but not saying that the tube jig isn't good. It is, but... I want to make sure that I can get some fish on tape.
Get what
tape,
you want.
So.
Okay. Well, that's it. If you're confident with it, that's what counts.
That's it. want to feel some little teeth on the end of this lizard, though. Don't make me look bad.
I tell you, if the sun was out, we could see these beds a little bit better. Folks, one thing, if you're going to be sight fishing and you want to see the fish, be sure you get some polarized glasses with amber lenses, because you can certainly see things in the water with them that you can't see with just regular glasses, even polarized. The amber lens is the thing that really makes the difference. Cuts out all this reflection that you're seeing right here and cuts right into the water. All right. You know, they quit on the tubes. I kept seeing fish move, and I just picked up this spinnerbait. And that's about the third, fourth cast with it, and he hit it right under the edge of the boat. And as clear as this water is, I'm surprised about that.
Yeah.
What I'm using is Kip's Baby Bass spinnerbait. And I tell you, folks, they're kind of hard to find. You can get them at Adventure Tackle and Reel in at Allied Sports Plus, but they're very effective spinnerbaits. They're not real big. I've had a lot of luck with them. I've been fishing them pretty hard the last few months, and I'm pleased with them, to tell you the truth. You know, for a little $3 spinnerbait, they're not bad. Is that sun in your eyes?
No, it ain't too
bad. It's in mine. All right, see if I can find another one, jump on top of this. That's nice. I like spinnerbait fishing. Sometimes I get bored just sitting there throwing soft plastics. And Susan, you like the soft plastics, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
I feel like I'm not doing something unless I'm cranking.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Under the boat.
under the boat.
There we go.
There he is.
Oh, come on, give me a little jump. You did when I first hit you.
They're not real active. It's
no, they
just
really
slowed
down. I'm hoping just, we got about an hour and a half before dark, and I'm hoping they'll pick up a little bit, because they certainly slowed down the last few minutes.
Yeah.
I saw that and run along that log and threw on him and he hit it.
Well, this little lady here's enjoying me feeding her some Oreo cookies. She's
getting the best
us.
Stuff, I'll tell you.
Yeah. See, I feed you better than he does. All you get is bread from him.
Well, I do feed her.
Yeah, but she likes them Oreo cookies.
But you got to watch her. She'll jump in the boat with you. She's already done that to me a couple of times.
You hungry, girl, huh?
She said, bah, talk to me. Talk to me. I ain't talking to you. I want to be fed.
She's lonesome out here all by herself.
Yeah, she is.
Okay, you want one more? See, it's got the little bluish center in it.
Oh, yeah.
I got them at Wally World, and my kids like them, so I figured this kid would like it. You want another one? Huh? Look at her. How about another one? Hey! Uh-oh, she hears somebody calling her. Oh, there you go. She's got it. There you go. Look, she's enjoying that one. All right, let me get in here good.
Go all the way in, yeah.
Nothing. Uh-oh.
You better
no.
not. Don't even think about it. Don't.
Is that goat ready to jump in the boat?
She's thinking about it real seriously.
Oh, no. Not when I'm in here. We got too much stuff.
No. You get back. No. See what I'm telling you? Look.
Uh-huh.
Get a cookie ready. You're going to have to deflect her here.
Oh, no. We got a cookie monster on the loose. Okay. Oh, okay. Wait. Here.
No.
Here. There's your cookie. Whoa. Yeah.
Throw it up on the bank.
And it's standing up. You seen how I tossed that? She's looking for it. She's like,
I warned you. You better save some cookies.
Oh, I did. She enjoys that. Oh, there, I think I spooked a bass right there. Come on. Let's
see. Yeah, I saw.
Come on, bass. Jump on that worm, man. Watch him go get in her limbs. All right.
That's probably the one that just hit that spinnerbait. You come right by there, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
He swirled at the spinnerbait, and she come behind me with the worm.
Yeah, I'm slick.
Oh, you're slick. You're sneaky is what it is.
No, I wasn't being sneaky. Come
That's
on, do a little bit of jump. Come on, do something. Do something. What's with you guys? You have no life in you today.
Well, they understand that you're probably going to let them loose.
I promise I'll let you loose.
Well, I fight it.
It's a pretty good size bass.
Yeah.
Woo. All right, you see that billy goat? Got a man.
She said, if I can't eat it, I don't want to even worry about it.
I bet she would eat this, huh? Ooh, did you swallow that?
Did he?
Yeah. Well, I might be able to get this out.
If it's not in his stomach, you're fine. You can just pull it out.
Yeah. All right, I'm going to let him have my bait. Bye-bye. Boy.
Need a new hook, huh?
Yeah. Okay. I went ahead and let him have my hook. I didn't want to tear up his throat.
Well, it's pretty, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
One of the great things about being out in the afternoon is you get to see these beautiful sunsets. Because when the sun rises, my eyes are tightly shut.
Oh, look at what I got. I didn't even really cast that far. I just kind of
He caught himself, huh?
Yeah, he kind of like hooked on, man. What you think about that little fishy? There you go. He liked that black and blue one.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
That's a Berkeley black and blue, huh?
Yes, Berkeley black and blue.
Yeah, we got a glimpse of it.
Yeah, you got a glimpse of it. I'm going to wipe the slime off my hands.
Oh.
Before I was worried because I was getting just Oreo cookie stuff on my fingertips. So... there's any more out here.
That's those little male bass.
Yeah,
I've seen some big ones move through here, but they're chasing the spinnerbait, and I'm stopping it, but they're just not hitting it.
Yeah. Oh, well, maybe they're just not that hungry.
Yeah, they're not active right now, that's for sure.
Maybe the females are stressing them out. Oh, I got one right underneath these limbs. What is with them? They're not very active. Come on. Yeah, there you go.
So
jump
you say.
A little bit.
So you say.
Come on. Let's see if you can do something else. Huh?
You say, yeah, I'm going to get this hook out of my mouth. He's fighting pretty good, Susan. All right, you can take him out now. You done gave him a good drenching.
All right. You ready to come out now? He's like, lady, what do you expect out of me, huh?
All right.
I'm black and blue again.
Black and blue. I might put on my tube and go back to it and see. Because they're definitely not doing anything with the spinnerbait except looking at it.
Yes. See how things change?
Yeah, really.
You just never know what they're going to bite on.
I went to my tube and got one.
Cool.
You hung up in a tree, aren't you?
Yeah, I was trying to hurry up and get my line up fast enough to get your fish. That's how I got hung up.
I looked up and I couldn't find my line, and it was running out away from the bank out to the middle.
Whoa, that's birds.
That's a fish. That's one of those.
See, I'm like stuck in the tree. This is what real fishermen do. We're not afraid to show our hang-ups.
Thanks for tuning in to this week's Bayou Country Outdoors. With your host, Susan Melton, and Maurice Fontenot. You can contact us by writing us at Outdoor Adventures Productions, 1019 Shady Lane, Westlake, Louisiana, 70669, or by calling 337-439-4063.